Hi there, I'm Michael Douglas, the celebrity hair colorist, and I'm gonna talk to you a little bit about home hair colorants and specifically covering gray hair. So if you're new to having gray hair, which a lot of you are, so it's starting to creep through, it normally starts in two or three areas first, which is temples and sometimes the partings. What I would say, if you've only got like 10 gray hairs, but you really wanna get rid of them, then just color those 10 gray hairs. So find a color that matches your own natural color, use a tiny bit of it and just apply it to the areas that you want. You don't have to color all your hair to start with. Now, if you start to get more and more gray hair, like 30 to 40% gray hair, then you probably do need to start coloring it all, but you've got lots of options. So first of all, you could go with semi-permanent color. Now, this doesn't cover 100% of that gray hair, but it blends about 50 to 70%. So if you take a single strand of gray hair with semi-permanent color on it, if you can imagine that that white translucent piece of hair would start to be filtered with about 70% of color. So you can still see it slightly, but you cover a lot of it. It gives a really nice blend and it's a brilliant introduction to covering gray hair. Permanent color will color it 100%. So if you want to get rid of it altogether because you hate it, then go with nice and easy permanent color and apply everywhere. Now, with regards to shade choice, you can go from anything from black, which is what they call a number 2, and you can go right up to a number 8. They'll give you 100% coverage on that whole range right up to light blonde. Now, if you want to go even lighter than that, I would recommend a 9, and a 9 will give you, again, a kind of translucent coverage of the gray hair. But what you find is if you want to be blonde and you're gray, a 9 will turn your gray hair a lovely kind of, what do you call it, kind of beigey blonde color, like a baby blonde color, so it works really well. If you want to go lighter than that, you can go to a 10 or 11 or a 12 and give yourself loads and loads of brightness and lightness, but it doesn't cover the gray hair quite as well. Now, other little tips are, is if you've got very stubborn gray hair, certainly around the front and around the hairline here, then apply to those areas first, and that way the color's got more chance of doing more work on those areas, if that makes sense. So apply to those areas first, and then follow the instruction leaflets with regards to covering the rest of your hair. And don't overdevelop the color, don't leave it on longer than you need to. Now, normally what you find is when you start getting gray hair, it has a different texture than the hair you're used to. It's usually a bit coarser. It normally feels a bit rougher. Now, you might not like that, obviously. By coloring that gray hair, it softens the surface of the hairs, which is this cuticle layer. So it takes the edge of that coarseness away. So coloring the hair can make it, I would say, smoother. It can make it more shiny because white hair, obviously light passes through it. And if you put some color on it, the light will bounce off it. This gives the hair a natural shine. So by coloring the hair, you'll get more shine. You usually find it's much easier to style. And if your hair's quite flat and it lacks body, coloring your hair swells the hair up and gives the hair body. So there's lots of other benefits to coloring your hair as well, other than just the color result you'll get. You'll find it easier to style, it looks shinier, and usually looks much healthier. Now, you might find you're in an emergency, you're due a night out, and you haven't got time to color your hair. Well, there are loads of options out there on the shelves. So first of all, you've got these root touch-up sprays. They just spray directly onto your dry, styled hair. They cover 100% coverage on the gray hair, and you get a color match to your own color. They work really well, and I use them all the time. You've also got things like powders, and there's various hair mascaras and pencils that you can draw onto the gray hair as well. Now, these are temporary solutions, so they will wash out, but you've also got Clairol's Root Touch-Up, which is a permanent color, and it has a little brush in it. You can apply it to the areas you need. It only takes 10 minutes to develop, and then you can rinse it out. Now, you might have been coloring your hair for years, and you would love the idea of growing out all that gray hair. But obviously, as you grow it out, you get this definite line from where the regrowth is coming through. Now, I'm getting asked more and more about this. What I would say is that go from using permanent color back to using semi-permanent color, and therefore you'll be able to grow out that line without it being too harsh. So if you can imagine the roots grow through, you've got about 2 centimeters of regrowth, use a semi-permanent that, wait for another 2 months, use semi-permanent again, and then gradually it'll start to fade away. Your hair grows roughly 1 centimeter a month, so in about a year to 2 years, you should be able to grow out a good 10 to 12 centimeters of hair, and you can have all your lovely gray hair back. So those are my top tips for people with gray hair. I hope they've been helpful to you, and I'll see you again soon.